There will be 10 billion people on this planet by 2050. 70% of them will want to live in the cities.
What happens today is we design something, we go and build it, and then we switch it on. And when we switch it on, we find that it uses more energy and its carbon emission impact is quite high.
40% of the embedded carbon comes from construction. That's just that's just an incredible amount.
Every material that we use in the world stays in the world. It doesn't ever leave. We have to be appreciative about what we expect that next part of the journey for that material to be.
There's very much a movement right now with technology around the art of the possible to make construction a predictable, managed process.
The built environment is a complex system of systems. It is the goal to create systemic change in this system of systems along agreed transition pathways with all stakeholders acting in sync.
We jointly need to come together in each and every project, set the ambition, work together towards a common goal.
This is our world. This is our opportunity.
Climate change doesn't know boundaries, does it?
Digital technology today is really transforming the way we can address the climate emergency.
Autodesk has a key role, I believe, in helping to enable the knowledge sharing and collaboration that is required of the industry. Today, I can collaborate in real time with projects in Sydney, Nairobi, Reykjavik.
Using digital twins to discover insights about these assets and then being able to track your decision making. We no longer want to be making trade-offs on sustainability. We have to make sure that this is not contributing to future carbon emissions, and we can make change happen very easily.
One major area that we see that's very simple is simply looking at, can we deconstruct the building? If we're not sure we're going to need this for 25 years or 100 years, why don't we design it for deconstruction?
Renewal and reuse of buildings is better than demolition and starting again.
Making decisions as early as possible is the best way to ensure that we can deliver on proper sustainable outcomes.
We hear a lot about ambitions, but we rarely see any results. I do not think that governmental and infrastructure owners are aggressive enough towards the necessary change that is needed in our industry.
We are focusing on the stakeholders with the biggest capacity to influence decision making, to set direction, and to catalyze action throughout the supply chain.
Standardizing how we deliver our projects and standardizing how we operate as a supply chain really needs some drive from clients.
The technology that we need to save the world already exists. We just need to scale it, because the scale of the challenge in front of us is one that demands immediate action.
There is no one that is going to win this battle alone.
Climate change is a planetary problem.
Policymakers have to be brave, make the call for all of us.
There is a commitment, but beyond that commitment, now there's going to need to be practical actions.
Each country can do their own thing individually, but that doesn't go far enough. I do think they need to be more aggressive. They need to come together to work on how international supply chains come together to build buildings and infrastructure.
It's up to business leaders to be brave.
We need to be bold and say it can be done. A digital twin for every building by 2025. Go. And we can be optimistic that technology really in this generation is transformational.
We can only deliver this change if we have faith, not just in our industry, but faith in our people in order to make a difference.